In this video, I'm gonna show you the weekend locations for visit different clocks and also use the volcano vent, air vent and a zipline in a single match. So make sure to leave a like and subscribe. Use code NOTBORIO40 on the item shop and let's go. Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Fortnite video. Today we have the challenges for week 8, which, as you can see, guys, I am the challenge master. I've completed every single challenge up until week 7, and week 8 release in 2 hours, but it has been leaked. But before we get into the challenges and show you the all the locations, the easiest and simplest, we go to the item shop, guys. And if you're new to... I've never seen these skins. These are really cool. But yeah, guys, if you're new to the channel, please do subscribe and like. And if you want to extra support me and find these videos helpful, please use code NOTBORIO40 on the item shop. It helps a lot, guys. And yeah, you can get anything after you use it. To use the code, just hit support the creator, right? NOTBORIO40, hit accept. And you can use any code for any creator. But if you use mine, thank you very much. Anyways, let's go to the challenges right now. Alright, guys, so these are the challenges for week 8. I believe Fire Monkey on Twitter leaked them for me. But anyways, guys, we have week 8 and we're gonna start with the second challenge, which is visit different clocks, 0 out of 3. And I'm gonna show you the clock locations because this is the most interesting challenge this week. And then we're gonna go over every single challenge. So let's go and visit different clocks. Alright, guys, so visit different clocks. We're going straight towards location number 1, which happens to be the most obvious location of them all. And it's the clock at New Tilted Towers. And you might know it, but the clock tower, the old school clock tower, got replaced with this new style Tilted Towers clock. So we're gonna go jump right towards it right now, so you can see it. But yeah, you would have to visit this clock right over here. And as you can see, it says the in-game time, which happens to be 2 p.m. right now, or 14 if you guys do the 24 hours. But yeah, this over here is the tower. You gotta come here, visit it, and that will be the first location for a clock tower. And honestly, this location is the easiest one. And can you even... I've never tried if you can break this. Oh my god, you can actually break the clock tower. Dude, I don't know how I feel about this. All these OG locations are gone, guys. I've actually never dropped here. That's kind of crazy. Anyways, though, guys, let's go to the next location where we're gonna have another clock tower, just like this one. And I mean, yeah, I did break the clock part. But anyways, that's location number 1. And dude, double pump. What are they even... Okay, whatever. Let's go to the next location because I'm overthinking the detail in Fortnite. So let's go. All right, guys. So location number 2 is actually inside of Junk Junction. And it's still related to Tilted Towers. But this location was added with the last update of Fortnite. I think 9.30 added this specific place. But anyways, you might have guessed it. But if you guessed it, comment in the comments, right? Comment that you guys knew it. But anyways, right over here in Junk Junction, as you can see, it's just a normal day in Junk Junction. You get the chest, but you might notice if you've dropped to this place quite often that this entire place has been like... I mean, it's supposed to be the junkyard of Fortnite, and there has been a lot of new things added. And you might have seen it already, but right over here, guys, we have a brand new clock tower. And yeah, I mean, it's a new addition, but this is the clock tower from Tilted. And in order to find the clock itself, it's actually located down here, guys. So you gotta come here and locate the clock. If you guys wanna do this challenge, you gotta come here and step right next to the clock. And it should be enough to do this challenge. But yeah, this is location number 3. We're now gonna go towards location number... location number 2. And we're gonna go towards location number 3. Which, maybe this is the hardest location, guys, honestly. Because not many people know that this place got updated. But there is also another location, which is not too easy. So let's go to that location. Right. Now, dude, now, let's go. Let's go. All right, we're going. All right, guys, we are headed towards the third location. And if you guessed it, you actually know the game very well. But anyways, it's actually the clock tower inside of Happy Hamlet, which got added season 7. And it's been here for a while. And as you can see, it's just an old school clock tower. But it has this roof that kind of prevents you to drop on it, which kind of made it an unpopular location. But there is the clock right on the side, guys. And I believe there is one on this side as well. Yeah, as you can see, it's a great location. And you gotta go right on top of it in order to get this challenge. So as I said, guys, you gotta go on top of it in order to complete this challenge. So you gotta climb up, I think, until this floor at least. And maybe this way you would still complete it. But yeah, I don't think it's gonna work if you guys go on the bottom. And look at what we got. We got some good old TNT. So we're just gonna use that and explode the clock tower, dude. That's kind of... Okay, yes. Yo! It's... Wow. These are leaked? Really? It's the new surfboard for the new event. But yeah, it's basically a drift board. Oh boy, okay, my bad. But anyways, guys, that was the location. Oh my god, dude. We actually managed to destroy the entire clock tower in seconds. But anyways, guys, so this over here was location number 3, next to Happy Hamlet on the minimap. Location number 1 was in New Tilted Towers, right over here. And location number 2 was up here in Junk Junction with the new clock tower from Tilted, from the old Tilted. But anyways, guys, this was this challenge. Let's go to the next challenge right now. All right, guys, the second challenge is apply shields 0 out of 400. And for this challenge, you just gotta apply shields. Minis work, chug splash works, chug jugs work. Literally everything works, but you gotta apply 400 shields to yourself. So that's not a hard challenge, but it's interesting because it's at least a little bit different. Anyways, next up we have eliminate opponents in Snobby Shores or Mega Mall. And I suggest, and honestly, like, I think Snobby Shores is better than going to Mega Mall because Mega Mall is super chaotic and not many people like the location. But if you want a hot drop, you can go Mega Mall as well. Anyways, Battle Pass challenges. First challenge is deal damage to opponents with assault rifle 0 out of 500. And I'll probably have some sort of a tutorial for this one, so let's roll it right now. Alright guys, so to deal damage with assault rifles to opponents, the easiest tip is that, honestly, even there is a lot of weapons that you might not know that are actually assault rifles in the game. So if you can see right here, the infantry rifle, it says assault over here, which means it's an assault rifle and it would count towards your progress. We have the suppressed assault rifle, which, I mean, this time it's in the name. But anyways, you can use any of these weapons to do damage and it would do the job. And you gotta do, I think it was 500 damage, which is quite a lot. But if you go on a 50v50 or 20v20 team rumble game mode, you should be able to just queue up and have any of these. You just need to find one of these and you can do 500 damage to just people in general and you would unlock this challenge. So this challenge is super easy. Let's go to the next one. All right, the next challenge is land at Paradise Palms, New Tilted, Mega Mall, Pleasant Park or Junk Junction. And this is just a land challenge. It's a filler challenge. So, I mean, whatever. You just gotta land at every single location in a different match. And a quick tip, you can use glider redeploy in 50v50 to land. Even if you don't go to that location, it still counts as landing if you just drop and redeploy at that location. Anyways, next challenge is actually kind of interesting. And we have use a volcano vent, an air vent, and a zipline in a single match. So I'm gonna show you how to use these three in a single match with a simple location right now. All right, guys, use a volcano vent, air vent, and a zipline in a single match. The best location is Sunny Steps. And you might have guessed it, guys, but this location, obviously, from first sight, you have the ziplines and the volcano vents. So yeah, you don't even need to drop exactly on Sunny Steps. You can drop towards the big expedition outpost in the jungle, which is honestly the best location for every single challenge, it seems. But once you drop over here, you can just go inside, grab some loot if you're lucky enough to find some, because I guess there is none. And over here, we have a zipline, and you gotta do one zipline. So here we go. That's the zipline. Then you gotta do a volcano vent. And also one of the new vents, the air vents. So I'm gonna show you the locations of all three, but yeah, here we go. That's a zip line. That's super easy. And as you can see, right over here we have a volcano vent, which would do the job. There is volcano vents only around the volcano location right now. I think they removed most of the other ones, if I'm not mistaken, or if they forgot to remove any. But yeah, as you can see, this would count towards a volcano vent. And right now we're going towards the air vent. And an air vent, actually, that's a super good tip, guys. You might not know, you might go look for them at Mega Mall or Tilted, but there is actually one right on this sky platform over here, guys. And as you can see, pressure plant got upgraded and that's kind of crazy. But anyways, dude, my game lag. We're going straight towards this new location and just jump on the sky platform, right? Jump on the sky platform, go on top. And as you can see, guys, right over here, we have two air vents. And this would count towards the challenge progress. And yeah, this makes the location I just shown you the best location, because you have literally everything. And maybe another good location would be that expedition outpost, because you go on the zipline, then over here you go on the volcano vent. But then I don't know if you can reach, well, that volcano vent, then you go to that one and then you reach this place. And again, that's the best locations right here. And I assume, like, if you go watch other people's videos, they would not know about this air vent. So yeah, that's why you subscribe to my channel and you get the easiest guides for all these challenges. That was crazy, dude. That was crazy easy to do. But anyways, guys, that was that challenge. Let's go to the next challenge right now. Go! Okay, guys, the last challenge is eliminations outside of named locations, 0 out of 5. So it's the opposite. Usually, we gotta eliminate certain locations. This time, you gotta go to somewhere where there is no location. So it might be a bit hard to get. But it's not too hard of a challenge if you play 50v50, especially because the zones end anywhere. So you can just go and play that game mode and you'll get your 5 eliminations outside of named locations. But anyways, guys, that's all the challenges for this week. These are quite interesting. So please do leave a like and subscribe if you found this video helpful, guys. Thank you so much for watching. The support on the channel has been crazy. We got a lot of people using the code again. We got 5,000 subscribers the other day in just one day, which is crazy. And it's all around the 14 days of a summer event, which, I mean, it wouldn't be. Actually, this event would still go for almost the entire season. So by the time you're watching this video, 100% this event is still gonna be here. So if you haven't done that, go in the description and do your challenges for the event, because as you can see, you get free rewards every single day. New one unlocks in 39 minutes. Already done the video on that one because I tried to be first on YouTube. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to hit the like and subscribe. And if you subscribe to the channel, you stay tuned to all the Fortnite news. You get the weekly challenges. You get the Fort Bytes every single time early. Like, I literally post it sometimes before it's even live in the game, which is crazy. And the extra challenges. And also the Fortnite news. So you get literally every single thing if you subscribe. And as you can see, I've almost completed the battle pass. We have 26 days left only. So make sure to do your challenges, guys. And I'll see you next time for another video. So thanks so much, guys, for watching this one. I'll see you next time. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.